Kuru was a disease very similar to CJD. It affected an isolated community in the highlands of Papua New Guinea and decimated that population. It was the practice in those communities for relatives to consume their deceased loved one, but unfortunately that led to transmission of this lethal disease in the community.
Kuru was passed on when people ate infected human brain. When they developed Kuru and died, they were also eaten. And so the lethal epidemic spread.
In 1996, we started a field project in Papua New Guinea to study the end of the Kuru epidemic. And I used to go out when patients had been identified in the community by our surveillance program. And we discovered incubation periods of the disease exceeding 50 years, which was an extraordinary length of time.
John Collinger's team found that patients were developing Kuru half a century after eating infected brains. It turned out that the incubation period for all prion diseases was determined by one single factor, genetics. The brain proteins affected by prion disease contain genetic material that we inherit from our parents. Each parent passes down either an M form or a V form of this genetic material. So everyone carries either a combination of M and V, or two Vs, or two Ms. These combinations affect how long people incubate the disease.
We found that the MVs were the ones that had the extremely long incubation periods, often more than 50 years. We had a concern from the start that this may also be the case with variant CJD, because everybody we saw with variant CJD was MM.
We didn't know whether that meant only MM people would be affected, which seemed a bit unlikely, or more likely that MV and VV people would be affected, but at a later time.
Half of the British population are MV genotype, but it wasn't known if they could develop VCJD until 2009.
The human form of mad cow disease, VCJD, is regarded as a disease of the 1990s. But there is a new victim, and crucially, not of the same genetic disposition as the 164 people killed by VCJD in the first wave.
One day we received a visit from four doctors from the prion clinic in London. One of the doctors told us that Grant was an MV gene type, a different gene type from everybody else in the world that had died of variant CJD. Didn't really mean much at that particular time, because I didn't really know what they were talking about, because obviously I'm a taxi driver, I'm not a specialist, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a professor of science of any type. We were only at that particular time worried about Grant, because his brain cells were basically dying one by one.
Grant Goodwin was the first MV victim, suggesting a new chapter in the VCJD epidemic.
He was a jack of lad. He just loved fun. That's another one, he's 21st. The policewoman, she's a stripper. She's got him handcuffed.
Oh, and my mum and dad was at that party too. My dad's like, oh, what is she doing?
Still got a cheeky smile, but... big giant, big gentle giant.
Yeah, that was his last T-shirt. Pretty small, because he had lost that much weight. It's never been washed. I wouldn't wash that smell away. No. If I've had a bad day, I can always come in and just lift that out. I just wish I could see a minute once more.
After Grant passed away, I sat down at my computer, and that's when you find out about the incubation periods of the various gene types. The incubation of Grant's MV gene type is 30 to 40 to 50 years. So as far as I'm led to believe, there is a second wave just round the corner of this illness. And the people that are incubating this haven't even got a clue that they're incubating it. It does scare me. Yeah, it scares me immensely. I could be incubating this. Margaret could be incubating it. You could be incubating it. We don't know. You'll never know until something happens.
Four years ago, a second MV death occurred. The CJD unit is still monitoring for any new cases.
So this is the room in the unit where we keep some of the samples from some of the people who died of variant CJD. There have been 178 deaths so far. There's still so much uncertainty about this disease, and one of the things that is uncertain is how many people in the United Kingdom are silently infected. And at the moment, I have to say, we're simply not sure. Every prediction that we have suggests that there are going to be further cases. This is obviously a tragic illness, not least because the origins of this disease were arguably preventable.
This basically says, my son Grant, in memory, murdered by greed and corruption, 1978 to 2009.
The greatest tragedy of variant CJD is that this is not a natural disease. It's an epidemic which we created. If the agriculture industry hadn't fed animals meat and bone meal, if the food processors hadn't scraped every last morsel of flesh off an animal, and if the Ministry of Agriculture, Fisheries and Food hadn't prioritized the farming industry over food safety, then all of the people who died from this disease would still be alive. That's the real tragedy.
I've got a list, a hit list. At Christmas, I remind them all by email, whether they open them or not, that this is my daughter. I send a photograph, I say when she died, and I say, and your actions did this. When you sit down to your Christmas lunch, you remember we sit down with an empty space because of the choices you've made. So when you make your next choice in Parliament, or your next choice in business, make sure it's a good one, because they have consequences.